In this video tutorial, I am going to create a column base in SolidWorks. So first thing is that make sure your units are in inches. So as you go here on the status bar, you can see the units are in inches, inches per second. Then go to the top plane and sketch. Now you need to select the corner rectangle or and select this region and draw a corner rectangle, and then give the dimension to this rectangle. This is 8 and its height is given as 3.5. Just click here on the zoom to fit, so the sketch will be fit according to the window. Click OK, exit the sketch. Now you needed to extrude base boss to extrude the rectangle, and the depth is 0.25. so feature tab, extrude, make sure this sketch is selected, and direction 1 end condition is blind, and this dimension is 0.25, the depth of the boss extrude. So as you perform this, you will see boss extruded in the design manager tree, and the sketch is under the boss extruded. So this is the first step or the first feature you just did. Then again you needed to select the top surface of this plate and make a sketch on it. So go to sketch, select this top surface and make it normal to you, and we are going to add a reference line, a center line. Center line is a reference line and does not become the part of the model actual geometry. It's needed here because the center of the cylinder is located on it. So go here, select this center line, and when you move your mouse on the on this edge you will see the center will be highlighted. So this is the center, or we can say the midpoint of this line. Select this point and draw a line, a straight horizontal line, and select the midpoint on the right side. Press your right mouse button and select OK. So then go here, select the circle to draw two circles like that, and give the dimension to these circles. So this first circle is, its dimension is 2.5, and this circle, its dimension is given as 2, and from this center to this edge, this horizontal dimension is given as 1.75. Then exit the sketch and select the base boss extruded boss tool from the feature group. So make sure your sketch is selected, and go to isometric or trimetric view, and this depth is given as, the end condition is given as, put here 3 inches. The depth of this sketch is 3 inches. Now we needed to make the holes on this plate. So go here on sketch and select this top surface, make it normal to you, and then select circle, draw a circle here, and give the dimension to this circle. So this dimension is given as 0.75, and from here to this side it's also 0.75, and the diameter of this circle is given as 0.65, and exit the sketch and make the cut extruded. So for the end condition, instead of blind, I am going to select through. The through will make a cut on hole. So that's it. Now we needed to make the linear pattern of this feature. So from the design tree, select this feature and faces, select this one, and then for the first direction we needed to select this edge. So for the first direction we wanted this linear pattern in that direction. This arrow is telling us that it will be done in that direction. And for the spacing and instances, under the spacing, this is given as 1.5, and for the number of instances we needed to select 3. And as you see, we needed to make in that direction pattern, and you needed to select this cut extruded, select linear pattern, and for the direction I am going to select this direction. This dimension is 1.5. So this is done like that. And for the direction 2, highlight this direction 2, and for the pattern direction we needed to define this edge because we wanted the pattern in that direction, and for this arrow is showing in that direction, we needed to change it to this direction, and this dimension is given as 2. And for the number of instances we needed to make 2. So this way it will make the linear pattern, and you can change the material or the appearance from here, from heads up tools, and give a green color to the whole and this yellow color to the whole part.